clocks all the way around. Run, you can run, bad clocks all the way around. Friends see me running, cause I'm become down.
Hi, and welcome to Where It's At from Vancouver. I'm Fred Latremoe. On today's show, in response to your response to our interviews, which has been very favorable, we have Tommy James and the Shondells, a group with the number one record, Creedence Clearwater Revival, both on tape for you to watch from recent shows here in Vancouver, the group you've been watching, Mock Duck, and Ralph with Joni Taylor.
I'm going down the road then, try and catch a ride. Going down the road then, try and catch a ride. I'm sinking.
It's a powerful song, Morning Dew, and it's been around for a lot of years, but it took Little Lulu from England to come up and make it a commercial and acceptable pop hit. And I'm glad she did, because a lot of people sort of have had a chance to listen to it now, know what it's about. Joni, thank you. It was great. I haven't introduced you to Joni's group yet, and they're not really Joni's group, but their name is Ralph. And I thought the best way that you should meet them was with them playing their instruments as only they can, jamming, in other words. And they're going to jam here in a song that you all know, but it may sound a little different, called Coming Home, Baby. Here's Ralph. Clearwater Revival are a second-generation San Francisco rock group who have had three successful straight hits in a row, starting with Susie Q, the old Rolling Stones song, and then I Put a Spell on You, which was done first by Screamin' Jay Hawkins, and then Proud Mary. Well, we had a chance to chat with them backstage at their show recently in Vancouver, and the Mock Duck will do I Put a Spell on You in 2 minutes.
Tom Fogerty on rhythm guitar and Stu Cook on bass and John Fogerty on lead guitar. For people who've been together 10 years, you guys must be more of a family than a band. Can you explain possibly why it took you 10 years to make it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Right.
Well, that's a good one.
Well, because we didn't decide to do it
all
about
time. 10 years.
Yeah, right. Right. Basically, I would say
bad managers, trusting way too many other people,
right,
putting our faith in too many other people, and believing too many of those hyped up theories that always creep up in the music business. Like I just said about worrying about, gee, should I be doing this or not? Because what are they going to say? You know, we had for a time, like our name was the Gollywogs. We had this manager.
How many names did we go to?
Really only those three. We were the Blue Velvets for 5 years, junior high through high school. And then we thought of a bunch of names, but we never used them. We thought we might be the Visions for a while, but it was really just groping, you know. Then the manager, our first record on Fantasy came out many years ago, and this manager, unbeknown to us, had, or unannounced to us, had put the name Gollywogs on the record. You know, we didn't know who that was, except it was our record, you know. So that's how we found out our new name. It was a big brainstorm. We wore funny hats and all dressed alike and danced around and all kinds of stuff. And it was really dumb, you know, but if you have a manager, you gotta listen to what he says, right? So instead we got rid of the manager.
You have a new single out called Proud Mary. That's your own song.
Right.
How do you, well, can you tell me about how that came about to be written and recorded? And why you decided on that from your new album as a single?
It's really the most single-oriented type song. It's, you know, the time is pretty obvious, but there's other songs on it. Good Golly Short also. The Proud Mary's got, like, everything is there. You know, it's got a really good melody. The beat is right. You know, it's I don't know, it's really catchy is the way I think of it. It's my favorite tune on the album for tune's sake, you know, for a single that you buy. There's so many things to evaluate music on, you know. It's just got a lot to say, and it says it in a very simple manner in a very short time, which makes it very appealing, I think.
The Mock Duck, and that incidentally is their latest single. It's on Baroka Records, available across Canada, so if you wish to, go out and buy a copy. They'll appreciate it. Tommy James and the Shondells, the number one group with Crimson and Clover, are with us in about 60 seconds to talk about everything from Hanky Panky on.
And you're looking at them right now, one of the most successful groups, in my opinion, over the last year and a half. Tommy James and the Shondells. Welcome to Where's That, fellas?
Thank you.
Seeing as how this is the first time a lot of Canadian people, young people, will have seen you, maybe you could introduce yourselves from left to right this way.
Okay, my name's Eddie Gray.
What do you play, Eddie?
Guitar, lead guitar. Mike Vail, I'm the bassist.
Fred Schwartz, Tommy James.
I'm hailing from Morristown, New Jersey. Pete Lucio, drummer.
What kind of music are you into personally and individually? You know, what kind of music do you each dig?
Beethoven.
It's amazing. You know, like I used to be, you know, hung up into it. Like I used to dig like R&B, and then I dug this, and then I dug that. But you know, everything is selling today, from, you know, MacArthur Park to Simon Says, you know, or Hanky Panky, you know. And so, you know, since people aren't hung up in a bag, why should, you know, a musician?
Yeah, that's like Mary Hopkins. Who would have believed that?
You've got to stay very flexible in your taste. You know, I just dig music.
What do you think of where the Beatles are at these days?
I love the things they're doing.
Well, it seems that their last album has proved that any direction they go, man, you know, it's fine. Like, it's more or less, to me, it's a comedy album.
Actually, it's
very funny. And
it's a fun album.
Yeah,
it's
right.
Just a whole lot of fun.
Anything they try is successful, and more power to them.
How heavily do you think England is influencing the States?
I mean, it's still quite a bit, I'd say. A lot of people think the contrary, but I think that England is still where it's at.
Yeah, definitely.
A lot of people still believe that long hair is out there.
Yeah.
It's just coming more and more.
In England, everybody has long hair, but Harold Wilson.
The agents went around there,
you know, the kids in England, like, they know the hit producers, you know, instead of the artists. You know.
Yeah, that's right, it's a real industry. I forgot my name. How do you like touring? You know, is this one of your first tours?
No. We did a tour 2 years. We hate tours, you know. I personally, I get crazy when I stay on the road too long. You know, we go out on the weekends. We just open our own publishing company and our own production company, and so it keeps us in New York pretty much during the week, you know, and then we go out on the weekend.
What kind of techniques did you use in Crimson and Clover? There's something that happens in the middle of that record.
Well, there's nothing to it. Why don't you get the hang of it? No, actually...
You just have to be really afraid of airplanes, is that it? Come right out of the airplane into the studio.
Yeah, well, no, that's not what we did. People come up to us and ask us, you know, like, what did you do? You know, it's so simple. We just ran the...
Don't tell them. Let them think it's for tough. Out of sight.
It was really hard.
It's not simple at all. Tommy James and the Shondells. Here's a song that the Mothers of Invention recorded, maybe you mothers should pay some attention to it, by Joni Taylor, called Mom and Dad.
Thank you. child was killed in the park today, shot by the cops as she quietly lay. By the side of the creeps she knew, they killed her too.
Hey, I hope you've enjoyed our little action-packed show today with Creedence Clearwater Revival talking instead of singing, and with Tommy James and the Shondells talking about things like Hanky Panky, recorded in 1962. I didn't know that. I could have guessed that. But and I hope you'll be back and watch for us in your television guide, whatever area you're in, for Where It's At from Vancouver. We have all kinds of interviews coming up. We've got an interview ready with the Beach Boys. And if you want an interview scene again, write to us, will you? Thank you. Here's Do Re Mi now by the Mock Duck.
Ask me why, tell me why, ask me why.